Welcome, everyone!
Meet we Jezebel!
We are the Brayton Brothers!
Interesting. This body you've selected for me isn't quite what I
Well, it's good for her apparent career she has on the side. According to her weird name.
What are you expecting? Yeah, apparently she's...
like a junk bot that's been hastily welded together. I'd say almost anything. However, I suppose I shouldn't be surprised, given your limited skill set derived from...
Mate,
to be fair, this is Ferret we're talking about. Although she has apparently gone smart enough to build these robots. Sarcastic.
Well, I was going to connect your head to Liberty Prime's body, but I decided to do a little arts and crafts instead. Disappointed?
If you're attempting to use sarcasm as an intimidation tactic,
I don't know. Who uses sarcasm as an intimidation tactic?
It's obvious.
Apparently we do.
Company, which suits me just fine. So, why don't you ask me everything you wanted to know?
So can you just randomly encounter her across the wasteland and ask this? The Mechanist? Or why so uncomfortable? I
know about the Mechanist.
Now there's a fascinating subject. The Mechanist.
I love the hands.
God.
Although I believe those giant hands are what apparently some people do refer to as Yayo hands. I'm not sure why.
It's because, so a lot of Yayo mangas are, helping, question mark?
Sure.
Helping the people of the Commonwealth? You?
Absolutely. It's my primary directive. The Mechanist instructed me to seek out and help the people of the Commonwealth. By my calculations, the easiest way to help a human is simply to destroy it. There's no point in prolonging the laugh of...
You'd fit right in with the Institute!
...the most efficient way to assist them.
This is the problem with robot brains.
...tends to result in numerous complex side effects.
I thought the purpose of them was that they're supposed to be, you know, humans who are kept alive, like they were with the detective thing.
Mm.
The Mechanist gave you these instructions to kill people?
Well, not exactly. The specific instruction was to help people. I merely interpreted the most efficient...
Yeah, the Yari hand...
So this explains how political conversations go.
Yeah, basically.
...25% survival rate. That means there's a 75% chance that despite my efforts, the human I'm assisting...
Much like how Superman went evil in the Injustice comics. Then one day she fell down the stairs and died!
Much like Superman in the Injustice comics. Yeah, so, like, the Yari hands thing is because a lot of Yari mangas are really bad artists and don't know how to draw hands. Like, not even to...
Can we stop like, the petty bickering and just get to the part where you tell me how to access the Mechanist facility?
I promised to
that wasn't what the question... That wasn't the option I clicked on.
Oh.
I clicked on Mechanist question mark and that was the response.
Hey, Prozy the video, I'll link it in again! I'm gonna kill your whole family! that was what I meant to say.
But yeah, so, like, the Yaoi hands thing is because the hands are just horribly out of proportion.
Isn't that just typical of all eyes, so?
No, like, horribly out of proportion.
No, you do not need to Google that. I don't want that in your search engine.
I've already got it in my search engine.
Why?
To show people Yaoi hands. Because it's funny. there is something I'm going to do.
Goodbye.
Though. I'm going to change her name. To actually be... her actual name, Jezebel.
Well, she's got an interesting career ahead of her. I mean, to be
fair... Also, why did it pop up with mozzarella as well?
I mean, to be fair, she'll be helping people... she'll be helping...
Miss Anne!
She'll be helping people a lot more like this than she would have with her previous directive of killing.
She will. It'll just, she can be friends with Fisto from New Vegas.
I have unintentionally created a monster.
There you go, Jezebel. Right. Yaoi hands.
Because attempting to get hands right just seemed to be a general...
Like, look. This is a famous... like, just in Yaoi. Not in anything else. Just... it's just unnatural.
Wrong, you are left-handed.
Doesn't matter if I'm left or right-handed. My hands are the size of your body.
To be fair, it still wasn't on the front page of Demon. I can't remember, it was a specific subtext, but...
This is the most common image I've seen. I don't think anything can...
There was
right.
a specific thing it was referring to, but I know Yaoi was part of it. It was a... Deviant... Should I go check the door because everyone else is outside?
Yeah, it might be an okay. idea. No idea who it is. I'll talk to Ada and...
Yeah, sure.
Ada?
Do this.
Is there a chance these robots could be misinterpreting orders?
Yes, I've considered the possibility. The contradictory nature of the mechanist's broadcasts are troubling. But the truth is, regardless of intent, the mechanist needs to be...
No, it was just sibling.
Oh, that's fine. Yeah, I don't...
It was fun. It was funny, he jumped up here... yesterday, because his car failed its MOT, so he jogged up here in order to borrow Kyrus's car, and Kyrus was like, so he jogged all the way up here instead of getting a lift or just waiting for me. You're like, what would you have done if I said no? Jog all the way back. Susie, quiet now.
I'll improvise.
Oh yeah, improvise. That sounds like fair.
I'll improvise when I get there.
Yes, the actual confrontation will allow you to make a more educated decision. Now,
again, like a robot would probably, you know, a typical robot sort of character would probably sort of disagree with going in with improvisation as your plan.
Jezebel.
I mean, you could have installed it on Jezebel.
I think you need it with you.
Ah.
So that means we'd have to do the quest with Jezebel.
Oh, she has a quest line?
Well, no, because I don't actually know if you can take her with you. I assume...
But you can just find her randomly.
Oh, no, she hangs around.
Okay.
Because she wants to see how it resolves. So Jezebel just lives in Sanctuary.
How's the fog got in your lungs? It's so foggy!
Damn clear sky, it's too foggy for me.
It was something that popped up on DeviantArt. I'm not sure if it was specific.
Well,
I know the word.
Fallout if we don't have an episode of walking.
I know the word gay was in there, and I'm fairly sure the word porn was in there too. But I'm not sure if it was like a subtext, like sort of furry or something like that. But it was a person like making sort of arc, just the characters like it's like I think the tagline was like suggestion for making gay porn. How about we make it consensual? Which, to be fair, that's in general with a lot of the sort of terminology, a lot of the porn material. It's like, why not make it consensual? You know, instead of making it... Oddly, it's an oddly amount of rape in it.
Yeah.
Because, you know...
Or blackmail.
Yeah.
But,
the most classic one, to my knowledge, the pizza delivery thing, is a consensual one. Although I do prefer all the jokes that can be surrounded by that. How about I treat you something else? Please, I need the payment for my family.
I need the money.
Or another one, someone did it with the Tom artwork, the Disturbed Tom artwork. Mm. And it's like pizza delivery man, and that'll be $15. And you got it goes me, hands him 20. The porn director. What are you doing? That Disturbed Thomas meme has been hilarious.
One of my favorite. I guess like it sounds weird to say, but like hentai memes are a subgenre of memes. People just crop images out.
Oh yeah, the hentai quotes thing. Yes, those are hilarious.
Like surprisingly funny. on your topic of a lot of the stuff not being non-consensual, there's one that pops around a fair bit, which is, as we all know, Judge, it's not rape if their pupils become hearts. It's like, someone wrote that.
There's a brilliant one from the mangaku made Electric Tale of Pikachu. Who, you know how the Electric Tale of Pikachu ends? Part of its ending shows Jesse and James having gone together as a couple.
Yeah, didn't
Jesse
he
actually made a manga about the pregnancy, as it were. Yeah. Or impregnation, as it were.
The sex.
There was another, like, sort of out of context quote I saw, which was, a character sort of saying, you're so addicted to dick now, you can't call yourself a man!
Wow. A common one as well is, wait, this isn't Smash Brothers, this is anal.
Again, this is the only sort of, like, our next playthrough, we definitely can't include any of this sort of stuff in.
Yeah, so, we might as well, everyone's exploding as well. We have to be child friendly.
Oh, good.
I forgot they were a thing.
Moving off that unpleasant topic.
Unpleasant? Don't know what you're on about.
Now, this is something that you may not know the entire context about, but I know you liked...
Why does that part of the water have waves, but the rest doesn't?
Actually, hold on. We mentioned the government earlier, didn't we? I can bring up the thing... which you might actually have something to say about this. Now, okay. We tried to avoid getting political, but this isn't too political, I'd say, because it relates specifically to gaming, and it's not really what I'd say a controversy.
Uh-huh.
Apparently, the UK government...
Yeah.
...are going to be investigating the online services of Nintendo, Xbox, and PlayStation on the basis of their auto-renewal function and whether it is actually going against the law.
Good, they should do.
Because I figured you'd have something to say about it, because you had an interesting experience with with Xbox Live, if I recall.
Yeah, they keep taking money out of an account that doesn't exist, and they won't let me cancel it, because I have to phone them to cancel it, despite... So on their website, they have a button that says, cancel subscription. You click on it, and it redirects you to a page that says, are you sure? Phone this number. It's like, no, just let me click the button to cancel. So... I never remember setting up the auto-renewal, either. We did it years ago. But the account that it was set up on doesn't exist. Because it was Curious's old account.
Yeah.
And they cancelled every subscription that was coming out of it and closed the account.
Mm.
Now, apparently, it's still... why is there a...
a mine just randomly in the water? Someone really didn't like fish.
How weird.
My fishing rod broke. Well, I guess there's a new way to fish. To be fair, apparently there is a fishing method which involves dynamite, so...
super mutants.
A legendary super mutant enforcer.
10 Pounds Bluff is under attack.
Is that close by?
Don't care.
Okay.
It's not my problem anymore. Yeah, so Microsoft...
Well, don't run that way. There's two vertebirds.
Yeah, I've got to go this way. This is the plot. So Microsoft apparently just...
What, they're building right there?
No, further.
Okay.
Microsoft apparently just kept trying to take money out of an account that doesn't exist. And so apparently I'm in debt to Microsoft now.
To the sum of £1 billion!
Because they... tried to take money from an account that doesn't exist and didn't at any point stop and go, hey, maybe this account doesn't exist.
Mm.
Like, surely after you don't get a payment, they just stop trying to...
Oh, there's the Verbert effect. Wow. Look at the game go.
Like, any other company, if a payment is failed to deliver, they just don't take it and stop the renewal. Surely. That's how, like, most of the places I know work.
It's funny, though. because I was in the Nintendo Life comment section reading up on this. We didn't have this whole government investigation happen on the same got reported on the same day. People were reporting on Prince Harry saying Fortnite should be banned.
Mm.
Which again, it is a softer punishment than I think of Fortnite players being publicly executed. So fair on to him.
Yeah.
But like a lot of people were saying, oh, I'm not sure why they're wasting their resources doing that. They clearly have a on-off switch or present on the Microsoft, Sony, or Nintendo. Clearly, this is the person's sort of fault. And no, yeah, the comment section, the other 50% of it was filled with people saying, I'm glad to hear this because I've had constant problems trying to get my Xbox, Nintendo, or PlayStation cancelled. And some people say, I've tried to, I've even clicked, it doesn't even tell you that you're auto-renewed first time you do so.
Nope.
And stuff like that. And someone said that you often don't know, the first time you often fall for it because you don't notice that it's actually renewed.
Yeah, it's in the...
And another person said that they didn't even make it too clear the first time. Like Nintendo's one, they'll only tell you if you're using a trial period whether you want to have it auto-renewal or not. Because they ask you at the time of asking if you want to make this a long-standing, you know, you no longer make it a trial but actually continue to have online. But if you get online from the get-go, they won't ask you.
Yeah.
Stuff like that. So there's a lot of people actually saying, this is a good idea because they don't have an opt-in system. It's immediate.
Yeah.
It should be an opt-in system.
They don't ask you to opt-in. They just do it.
And other people have said they were having trouble contacting Sony, Microsoft. Not heard too much about Nintendo.
They
but...
actively make it as difficult as possible to cancel the subscription and force you to go out of your way to the point where it's easier just to remove your account.
Mm.
Like, especially for me, because, like, the card doesn't exist. I can't just go onto online banking and cancel it. Because it's not there.
And then there's me, who never uses online banking.
I can't even go to the bank and make a comment about it. Because it's not there. It doesn't exist. And the amount of customers we've had that have come in and complained... about the fact that, because something else that's interesting.
Yeah. But there's only like one terminal working out of, oh, I know two.
So, you know how you can get month subscriptions?
Yeah.
For the onlines. If you get a month subscription,
like I had like a 1 year subscription and then when it ran out, it just ran out. I didn't.
Yeah, the year and the 3 months. They run out, they run out.
Yeah. It's honestly the best way to do it.
The 1 month one will set up a monthly payment thing.
What?
Yeah, it sets up an auto-renewal even if you buy the like physical card.
But you've only bought it 1 month. So you only want it for the 1 month.
Yeah, and it'll set up a auto-renewal system.
God, and that
for a month, when a month is the least... financially stable way to do it because it's the most expensive like in the long run.
Someone actually did say they had a similar problem. They on Nintendo Life they said that they'd gone like they barely used their Xbox 360 but they got the 1 month online thing for getting a demo, I think it was Sonic Generations, and then they hadn't used it for a while and they suddenly checked their sort of bank and noticed tons of payments going out.
Yep.
So after several years.
Yeah.
After a good year, you know, that...
It's set to do an auto-renewal. Same way,
But the 1 year doesn't, because I don't have online at all.
Year and 3 months don't, just the monthly.
So, good. I would have noticed if my money came out, because I actually keep track of my money very tightly with a Grimm Brothers account book and everything.
I've started keeping a track of my money as well, ever since Microsoft are a bunch of...
To be fair, I also have... Although I've yet to sort all of our bank details are basically up here.
Yeah.
Sort of, you know, every sort of...
But the other one that annoys me is Now TV.
What's that?
So it's basically Netflix.
Do you know what TV I shows. Think it's called HBO is?
Yeah, I know what HBO
okay,
is.
Okay, because there's people were talking about it, it's like you know, it's no different than HBO. And they're like, what the heck is HBO?
I think HBO is an American network.
Oh, okay.
TV. Now TV is basically like that, right?
So I guess the closest is like Sky then?
Yeah.
Okay.
With our bundles...
Because Sky is what we're familiar with.
Yeah. With our bundles, we give a Now TV trial. Like 2 months. free kind of thing. It, don't know why, I assume we've got a partnership with them. Here. So, you know, it's just a trial. I don't remember if they've changed it, but we had so many customers complain about this thing.
It's awesome!
We have to warn customers about it.
And it continues to be awesome! Not your thing, I mean, the door's really awesome.
Yeah,
not your thing's dreadful.
They wanted to keep it fucking secure. Pretty sure that's what a paranoid man's doorway looks like. We'll probably save and then end the episode once we finish this.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was just a trial. So, when you set up this free trial, it would ask for card details, which is normal for a lot of things, but, you know, not exactly ideal. The reason it asked for card details is because despite the fact that it was a free trial, it set up auto-renewal without asking. I think every company, by law, should have to have an option to opt in and opt out. And it should always, by default, be set to opt out.
I don't...
Is that happened with Amazon Prime, actually. I put up a free trial for Amazon Prime because I wanted to try and get... I think it was connected to, like, Twitch Prime or something, so I could get one of the Hearthstone heroes. I don't think I ever got it in the end.
That annoying exclusivity thing. Yeah.
But, yeah, so, like, cool, I'll use this trial. I've got presents that I have to order from here anyway because I can't physically get them anywhere else. And then, like, a couple months later, I'm like, what the hell is this £8 payment coming out of my bank? Turns out, yet again, without asking for permission, Amazon had set up a auto-renew system.
To be fair, this is a company which literally runs slave trade, effectively. Yeah. So.
What confused me is that I never put my card details in when I set up Amazon Prime. So it had taken my card details from my account, from like the payments that I used, to buy stuff.
So you didn't even give them their information?
No, it just went, oh, I see the information in your account. I'm taking that.
Dreadful. And yet people still shop at Amazon. It's like, people go about all this moral crusade of stopping all these corrupt companies. It's like, no one puts the, you know, actual foot down and actually does proceed to stop paying for it sort of thing. I was actually really impressed the other day on the radio.
I have stopped shopping at Amazon now.
I was actually really impressed the other day because I get annoyed quite often when people, like, they talk big on the environment, but they often won't, you know,
do anything about it.
Yeah, they'll make protests, or they'll sign a petition, or they'll have a march, but they won't actually change their lifestyle to protect the environment. That's too much for them. But I actually listened to the radio, and there was actually a couple of teens who did actually sort of start, you know, they proceeded to, one of them decided to opt out of getting driving lessons and started taking the bus or walking to their destinations.
Yeah.
One of them stopped using Ubers entirely, because they realised they were using Ubers a lot just to get to the train station and back.
So
they were just waking up early to do the walking instead.
I saw show about...
Which really impressed me that people... And, you know, of course, like, some people, they start growing their food. And it was really nice to hear people who could talk big about the environment, but actually willing to do something.
Yeah, on that same note, I saw a show talking about things like that. And they'd gotten a family to try and go plastic-free for, like, a week.
That is pretty hard given how much food comes in plastic, but it is containers.
They reduced it from like a full bag of recycling to about 4 things.
Wow.
And they kept it up. The person in, like, doing the show was like, have you managed to keep it up? And they're like, yeah, there are some things that, like, we can't do, but, like, we've managed to find alternatives for most things. So, food-wise, they have their own little boxes and they go to the local stores. And they are fortunate. They live in one of the areas where the local stores have, like, the fill-your-own stuff.
Oh, yeah.
And so they're able to make use of that. But the most interesting one was cleaning products.
Okay.
So, of course, like, cleaning products all come in plastic bottles and stuff, you know. All your sprays are in plastic
bottles. And unlike, say, a water bottle, you can't just reuse the water bottle to refill it, because, of course, the cleaning product...
So, yeah, what they had is, like, 3 or 4 plastic spray bottles.
Yeah.
And that was it. And instead, I think it was, like, a website or something, or, like, a store or something sold them. They come in, like, a little cardboard box and a tray. And you get little tablets.
Okay.
And you put the tablet into the box, use water, and it creates the cleaning product.
That is incredible!
And I was like, that is something that should just be sold in supermarkets. I don't know if it is, but I want to find another
old-fashioned sort of thing. Like how before, in sort of Dad's days, they used to have a return policy and all the sort of bottles and such.
Yeah.
I mean, heck, they used to use glass bottles back then. So you'd get a sort of drink, and you'd get a little money back if you returned the bottle and it'd be reused.
Yeah, they used the glass bottles as well from the
milk. I love milk out of a glass bottle. Oh, that was so good.
I just love milk. A lot of people don't like milk.
I've never understood that.
I like milk. I'll fight you over milk.
Cheers, everyone!
Bye.